in Chicago, it was a couple years ago now, and went in this little restaurant for breakfast, and I'd say most of you know who Steve Winwood was, is, not was, is. Played with Clapton, all those guys. Went in there, and he happened to come in, and we were sitting there, and Nancy was talking to me, and I looked at her, I'm like, shh, I gotta hear his voice. And I got that look from her of, oh, don't shh me. he came in with his assistant, was standing there, and we were taken up to our table, and the owner was actually our waiter. And I asked him if he knew who Steve Winwood was. Oh, of course I do. And so I think that was him that came in downstairs and was waiting to be seated. And he goes, oh, okay. And so he goes down and comes back a little while later, and he goes, man, good eye. He pulls out his phone, and here's him and Steve Winwood standing in front of the restaurant, arm in arm. And I said, that's supposed to be me in that picture, man, not you. But, so we had a good laugh over it. And, I don't know what made me think of that one. It was a fun trip, and actually he was playing at, I believe, the Apollo or something there that night, and it was a sold out show, and so there was our brush, not brush, with the fame. Yeah, so, but anyway, I just thought I'd share that. I don't know why. Anyway, this is a song kind of loosely based on a event that happened back in 1917 in Springport, Michigan. I don't know if anyone's from there or knows much about it. I don't know a lot about the town. There's a cool little racetrack there. But I'd heard about this story and decided to write a song. And most of it's pretty close to, I think, what happened. So anyway, this is called Springport. You better run for cover. The sky is dark and wild. And no sirens or warnings. Things starting to fly. Thank you.
but what happened here? I was nearly destroyed. This little town of Springport is strong and survived. Tornado's coming. Our town apart. Even when it's all over, I'll never rip from my heart.